Let's look at Matthew chapter 25.
From verse 41. Then shall he say also unto them on the left hand, Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. He will say to these selfish people, stingy people, the people that saw him and hungered and they gave him no meat, the people that saw him thirsty and they gave him no drink, the people that saw him a stranger and they took him not in, the people that saw him naked and they clothed him not, the people that saw him sick and in prison and they visited him not. You see, the lives of many people are lived in selfishness. They never give any part of their substance or food or money or clothing or time or talent for the benefit of other people. And Jesus said that on the last day he will tell them, Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire. And I must ask you, you have a lot of talents and a lot of gifts. Do you ever give it out for the benefit of other people? You have the message of salvation. Do you ever give it out for the benefit of those who are not saved? You have the knowledge of the Bible. Do you ever give it out for the knowledge of those who are in ignorance? You have the message of deliverance. Do you ever give it out for those who are in prison and in captivity? If not, on the last day you will hear, You did not live your life with eternity in view. Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Verse 46, these shall go away into everlasting punishment. Revelation chapter 14, verse 11. And the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever, and they have no rest day nor night, who worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receiveth the mark of his name. Those who serve the Antichrist and do not serve Christ. Those who have the spirit of Antichrist, they do not have the spirit of Christ. You cannot be neutral. You are either for Christ or for the Antichrist. You are either having the spirit of Christ or the spirit of the Antichrist. Little children, now it is the last time. And I see a father, the Antichrist shall come. Even so now are there many Antichrists. Thereby we know that it is the last time. We know that there are many Antichrists now. And if you are serving that Antichrist, you are serving the beast, you are not serving Christ. It says, the smoke of their torment ascendeth up forever and ever. They have no rest day nor night. The next time you are tempted to deny Christ, think about the fact that one day you will die. After death, where will you spend eternity? The next time you are tempted to receive the attitude, the spirit, the motivating factor in the Antichrist into you to become a little Antichrist, remember, one day you will die. And after death, where will you spend eternity? The next time you are tempted to become a partner to people that are opposing Christ, to people that are running away from Christ, the next time you are tempted in your language, in your attitude, in your action, to oppose the doctrine of Christ, remember, you can oppose today, but one day you will die. After death, where will you spend eternity? Daniel chapter 12, verse 2. Daniel 12:2, and many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Friends, all the sins you are trying to hide today, so you will not have shame, will be revealed on the last day. And that time you will wake up to everlasting shame and everlasting contempt. Are you a preacher and you are living in immorality with ladies in the church and people don't know it today and you cover up? Well, maybe you can avoid coming under shame today, but on that day you will wake up to everlasting shame. We will know one another in heaven. There will be years, thousands,
hundreds of thousands, millions of years, millennia,
for eternity, we'll just be in heaven together.
We will know who is absent. If we don't see you the first day, we'll be looking for you the second day, first year, 100 years, 1,000 years. All through eternity, we'll search all the mansions and all the streets of gold, and we cannot find you.
Then there will be everlasting shame. Then we'll, those of us who get to heaven, will be talking to one another.
Do you remember Sister so-and-so? How she used to lead chorus, how she used to lead prayer meeting, how she used to be very authoritative and preaching the word of God. Oh yes, we remember. Oh, we didn't know she will never make it.
And then everybody will have you in contempt. All those things you are hiding out, we will know them.
Oh, we will say, she didn't make it because she was living immorality secretly.
She was having pride and bitterness and hatred secretly.
Oh, we didn't know that all that type of preaching and ministration, we didn't know that that lady was just a hypocrite.
Or maybe you are a man, and when you come up here to preach, people just shout and say that's the voice of God. But internally, you are a rotten man, corrupt man, polluted, defiled man. You have corruption and dead men's bones inside you.
You live hypocritical life.
You live in sin. You have defiled many women. And whenever you preach, people will cry and pray and bow down and say, oh God, let me make heaven. You will be like the people at the car park that tell people to get into the vehicle, and then the vehicle takes them away. You are not going anywhere. And you know, when we get to heaven, we'll see one another, we'll know one another. Where is house fellowship leader so-and-so? So where is zonal leader so-and-so?
He didn't make it.
He didn't live with eternity in view.
We will know it on that day. And it is not long. The time is coming. Very, very soon. We will soon die. Time is short.
Time is not too long. Apart from that, the rapture will soon take place. When those who are ready, those who are living righteously, they will be taken out of this world.
My friend, on that day, where will you be?
What is your conscience telling you now?
Should something happen now and you die right now, where will you spend eternity?
Should a trumpet sound now and a voice of the archangel is heard now and Christ takes the saints home,
where will you be?
Will you be among the people that will have everlasting shame, everlasting contempt? You carry Bible, but they have your name in the attendance of the people that are visiting prostitutes. The prostitutes know your name. The prostitutes have your money. You visit them. You go to them. And here you are carrying Bible. And you are walking in the kitchen. Or you are walking among those who are serving food. Well, that day will reveal it. When everything will be plain. When we will know everything that has ever been hidden. There will be no mystery. There will be no hidden thing. And those who are right with God, righteous in Christ, they will rejoice forever and ever. But those who are hypocrites, Pharisees, churchgoers, nominal Christians, members of deeper life in name, but they don't know God, they don't fear God. In secret, they live like an animal, like dogs and pigs. But openly, they don't wear jewelry. Say, well, I don't watch television, I don't do this, I don't do this. In hell, you'll go and be telling your companions in hell you didn't watch television. You'll be telling your companions in hell you are not smoking, you are not drinking. What a shame it will be forever and ever. And the people will tease you. The people, they will torture you. They will say, deeper life member, what are you doing here? You attended every retreat they organized in deeper life. You had Bible from every preacher that preached in deeper life. You have all your shelves tied with cassette and with deeper life books.
and you are still here in hell. You have Dick's Bible, you have Thompson's Chain Reference Bible, you have small Bible, big Bible, annotated Bible, amplified Bible, every type of Bible, language Bible, English Bible, with all the Bible you carried in your house, what are you doing here? What will you tell them? Let's rise up and pray. Where will you spend eternity? Will you be in heaven? When Christ will come, will you be in heaven? When Christ will call his own home, will you be among the people of God? Are you a child of God? Are you born again? Are you living a righteous life? Are you living with eternity in view? Is Jesus your Savior? Is Jesus your Lord? Are you living a life in the secret, in the public, that when Jesus will come, he will take you home? Or are you a hypocrite? Are you a hypocrite? Are you a hypocrite? Are you living with heaven in view? Are you a child of God? Where will you be on that day? When the trumpet has sounded, when we have heard the voice of the archangel, when the dead in Christ shall rise forth, and we which are alive shall be caught up together with them to be with the Lord forever and ever. Where will you be on that day? Seeing that all these things shall be dissolved, what manner of men and women ought we to be in all holy conversation? Because all the elements of this world will be melted away. What type of life are you living in preparation for the coming of the Lord? Are you a real Christian? Are you born again? Are you a child of God? Are you living a clean life? Are you living a pure life? Are you living with eternity in view?